Hello everyone, it's Jin Teacher coming to you again from Reading Town. Let's take a look at today's article. So our article says, how do fish breathe underwater? So let's find out. We know that you and I, we breathe air, but fish, they need to breathe too. Let's find out what and how. So like humans and other animals, fish need oxygen to breathe. So oxygen is something that we cannot see. It's in our air and that's what we breathe in. Humans have lungs that take in oxygen, but fish don't. So lungs are inside of our body, and in Korean they're called pae, and that's what we use to breathe and take in oxygen. But fish don't have lungs like we do in their bodies. Instead, they breathe through their gills. So gills are found on the side of a fish, and it's usually cut open, and that's where the water goes in. So they take water into the mouth, and then the water passes out into the gills. So this is how they breathe. It says, the gills remove oxygen from the water. So did you know inside water there is oxygen, but not in the way that you and I can use it. So it's inside the water. So it says here, the gills take away, it removes the oxygen from the water. So it separates it. The fish's body then takes the oxygen while the water moves out of the tiny gap or space under the gills. So we see the gills on the side of the fish, and when they take water in through their mouth, they're able to take tiny bits of oxygen in the water, and then they pass it out, the rest of the water, out through the gills, so on the side of it. So as the fish swims around, they're breathing underwater using their gills, not their lungs. Very interesting. So we know that in our fish tanks, you can watch fish, how they swim about, and take a look at their gills. Sometimes they move it, they flap it, and in that space, they're passing water as they're taking in oxygen through the water, through their mouths. So very interesting. Fish do breathe underwater. So here, let's take a look at the blanks and fill it out. It says, fish need oxygen too. Do they need it to eat? Do they need it to sleep? What do the fish do with oxygen? So just like you and us, you and me, they need it to breathe. So fish, like this goldfish here, they breathe underwater using the water, oxygen, and their gills. So fish breathe through there, I just said it. So it's that kind of space on the side, and they use it to pass the water. So they use their gills. So I know that sharks have several gills, and most fish, they have this one larger opening. So here, the gills remove oxygen from, where do they take the oxygen from? Do they take it from the air? No, because they're underwater. So they take the oxygen from, that's right, they take it from the water. So in the different fish tanks that you have, the reason why we need to constantly replace and clean the tank, yes, it gets dirty, but also the oxygen in the water can be used up, so that we have to change it and give them fresh water or fresh oxygen in the water. So here, let's look at the last questions. It says, humans have something that takes in oxygen. So what do we have? Do we have lungs? We have hands and skin, but where do we take in oxygen when we breathe? Do we breathe with our hands, right? Do we use our hands to breathe? Do we use our skin to breathe? And we said that we use our organ inside of our body called the lungs. So we have it, but fish don't have lungs, right? So we can find our lungs deep inside of our chest. B says, a fish takes water into its fins, into its mouth, or into its tail. So where does it take in the water? Does it take it in the tail in the back? Does it take it in through their fins, like kind of the tiny flaps on their sides? Or does it take it through their mouth? So we know that the water goes out of the gills, but where does it come through? And it comes through in the front, it comes through their mouth, right? And the last question, it says, water moves in or under or out of the tiny gaps or space under the gills. So does it move in the in of the gaps, under of the gaps, or out of the tiny gaps? So when we see the fish, they take in water through the mouth, and then it goes out of the tiny gaps or the space under their gills. So we know that now fish breathe just like you and me, but they just use different parts. We use our lungs, but fish use their gills, and there's actually oxygen inside of the water, and that's what the fish are able to remove and separate as they take it in through their mouth and breathe it out. That's why they always need to move, because if they're not moving, it cannot pass through. So very interesting. So the next time you see fish, you can watch it actually breathing, kind of like you and me, but using different body parts. Very interesting. Hopefully you learned a lot from today's article and you share this with your friends and your family. Until next time, I'll see you again. Goodbye, everyone.